Hello, my name is Steve, and I'm gonna give you some advice about fucking writing. Now, if this is your, God forbid, your first fucking video of mine that you've ever seen, don't expect any of this to be coherent in any way, because I'm a fucking moron. That being said, I am a moron who likes to write, so maybe you'll learn something. If you are a normal viewer of my fucking channel, which God knows why you fucking actually like my videos, I am not rubbing on Grizzly Fine Cut, got Copenhagen Snuff. And I'm gonna try. Regret anyway. Sorry, someone just messaged me. And if you're wondering why I never fucking wear my glasses in my videos, it's why I just don't. I honestly don't know why. So I don't feel like putting them on. That's why I need to fucking squint to see my fucking TV. And my fucking phone, which is just as far fucking away from me. Anyway, you wanna fucking write. Listen. So, like, it's like making a movie. Except on a paper. With words. What I'm trying to say is show, don't tell. That's like, you know, that's like the biggest thing in like making a movie. Even if you've never made a movie, I'd imagine you've probably heard that before. You know, show, don't tell. You want to show what your character's feeling instead of just saying what your character is feeling. Also, this random tip. Take it easy with the fucking pronouns. Like, you can use them, you know, use them, but, like, don't go fucking, you know, don't be every sentence, he did this, she did that, fucking, because that gets exhausting to read. And if you're writing in first person, don't start every sentence off with, I did this, then I did that, you know, just, I mean, if you start off like that, it's fine. But, you know, you'll get better eventually. But, you know, just try to limit it. That's what I'm trying to say here. Because, like... But especially with... As soon as I try to make a fucking video, everyone starts trying to fucking message me. Like, 5 people are messaging me right now. Let a razor fuck Chuck Berry on the real trailblazer. Let's never run even ahead of me. Don't think they ought to be. I'm Jerry Lee. Hillbilly insanity. Sorry. I really fucking love this song. But, yeah. Like, when I write, I've been told that I paint a very good mental image. I personally don't think so, but I've been told that I do. So there's that. But, like, it's just, like, you wanna give detail, but you don't wanna give too much detail. Like, you don't want to... You know, you don't want to spend 5 fucking pages describing someone's hair color, but, you know, you don't want to, you know, but if you want to emphasize the color of their hair, you don't want to say one word. You don't want to say, oh, she had red hair. You know, you could say she had hair as red as something that's red, you know? You know, hair as red as a fucking can of Grizzly Fine Cut Natural. I wouldn't recommend using those exact words because I can't imagine many people are actually going to get that. Especially if they're not American, because, you know, dip is a very American thing. But, you know, keep, like, if it's something mundane, like someone's hair color, but you want to emphasize it some way, you know, give it a sentence. But don't give it more than that. And don't go into detail like that for every feature. If you're trying to, like, paint a good description of someone's, like, face or body, you don't want to describe every feature like that, because that just gets fucking tedious to read. And to write. You know, you're not writing to fucking pad out words here. You're not writing a fucking essay. You're writing a creative writing that you want people to read and to enjoy. That's the point of it. Three pinches will be enough. But, yeah. Like, if you're trying to describe someone's entire body, I would say give it at most a paragraph. At most. Like, you don't, like, that's what I'm trying to say. You want to give detail, but you want to give the right details and not too much of them. And what are the right details? Well, that's something you just kind of learn by yourself. You know? Or if you, like I said, you have a character, and like I said, I gave the example, if you want to emphasize their hair color. Like, there's that. Or their eye color, or the fucking shape of their nose. I don't know. But, like, if you want to emphasize something about them, you know, that's what you do. And something I personally do is I write in the first person a lot, most of the time. I have the most experience in it. I stole this, and then steal it, so you can't really steal a writing technique. But I got this idea from George R. Martin, the writer of, you know, Song of Ice and Fire. Where when he doesn't just, like, he does, I forget the exact name of it, but I think it's, like, third person limited. Like, it's not first person, but it's not, like, you can only, like, see the thoughts of, like, the character that the POV chapter is of. I think that's third person limited. Don't fucking quote me on that, though. I'm not a fucking English fucking major or anything. What I'm trying to say is that he italicizes thoughts. Like, so you can throw in a thought, but, and so you don't have to say, I was thinking. It flows a lot better if you just italicize, like, the, like, one line of thought. And I feel, like I said, that flows a lot better than I was thinking, or something along those lines. And another really basic thing, but even I fuck it up all the time, is try to stick to a tense. You know, I'll admit, I fuck this up a lot. But try to stick to a tense to the best of your ability. You know, whether it's past tense or present, you know, try to stick to it. You know, like, don't say, you know, I... Don't be like, fucking, we walked down the thing, we walked down the path, and then in the next sentence be like, we are now sitting on this. Like, I guess that kind of works. I'm fucking up here. I don't know how my brain works. I don't know anything. If you're taking advice from me, then goddamn. Oh, anxiety. I want to touch on this. If you aren't anxious, don't have anxiety and want to know how to write it or write a character with anxiety. I know some people be like, well, you can't write characters that don't have these things if you don't have it. Like, I don't fucking care. You know, I'm diagnosed with anxiety. If you want to write a character with anxiety, don't write a fucking head. Doesn't bother me. But I'll give you some tips about what anxiety is like, so maybe it can help. One, you shake a lot. You move a lot. Like, you have a lot of movements. I remember my anxiety, right now my anxiety is really bad, but at a point, my anxiety was so bad when I was in a mental hospital. That's a story for another day, and I tried to kill myself, got put in a mental hospital. Don't worry about it, like I said, that's a story for another day. I was so anxious that I was, like, sitting in a chair, and I was like this. And one of the other guys on my unit seriously came up to me and he said, hey man, are you withdrawing from something? Like, he seriously thought I was going through some sort of fucking withdrawal. That's how bad I was fucking shaking. Like, in an anxiety attack, which I've had, been having a lot recently, fucking sucks, by the way. They vary in levels of intensity. But, generally, you know, it's hard to breathe, your heart beats really fast, your mind is just fucking uncontrollable, going a mile a minute, just fucking, it's bad. I would say that would be the best way to just, like, portray it in writing would be with racing thoughts, because that is a big part of it, at least for me, is when I get really anxious, my thoughts are just going fucking crazy. So, yeah, there's that. If you'd like to know more, just fucking message me on fucking whatever platform. My fucking Discord is not Jebediah4062, and that's not with a K, because I'm a furry. My Twitter is at SteveWhiteTrash, the SWNT, SWNT are capitalized. My Telegram is Confederate Jebediah. At Confederate Jebediah, and the C and the J are capitalized. And for some godforsaken reason, you want to follow me on Amino. My name is Fergus the Snow Leopard. But yeah, I'll see you guys next time.